Hi folks, welcome back. I hope you're all doing well. So today I'm looking at a paper that came out just a couple of days before I'm recording this. And this paper tries to empirically examine how large language models use very large context windows. Back when ChatGPT came out, I think its context window size was in the range of 4K token. But as all these AI companies have thrown more and more compute power at the problem, they've been able to train these LLMs with larger and larger context windows. And the latest LLMs have much larger context windows now. For example, GPT-4 has a context window of 32,000 tokens. The Claude LLM has a context window of 100,000 tokens. And the authors in this paper are saying, well, wait a minute, these large context windows sound like they would be awesome because you can throw a lot of information into your initial prompt, but is that how it really works out? I won't bury the lead here. Just like it says in their title, Lost in the Middle, what they see is a U-shaped curve. If you plot the position of the document within the prompt on the x-axis and the accuracy of the answer given on the y-axis, they see a U-shaped curve, which means that if the document that you're looking for or the document that you're asking a question about in your prompt happens to be near the beginning or near the end of this really large context window you're looking at, then the accuracy is fairly high. But if that document happens to be in the middle, then the accuracy falls by a lot. In fact, it's worse than this red line, which is the accuracy of a bare prompt without any of these documents, the closed book case, so to speak. Let's look at how exactly they've set this experiment up. Within their context window, they have some number of documents, K documents, where exactly one of the documents has the answer to the question being asked in the prompt. And the other documents are just distractor documents. Here's a concrete example of a prompt that is set up this way. You start with a general instruction, and then you simply put the text of a bunch of documents in the prompt, and then you ask a question about the text that was in the prompt. And what they're trying to measure is the question being asked about pertains to one specific document, the bolded one in this case. How, if you vary the position of the document within the prompt, does the accuracy of the answer change? And this graph is a more detailed version of the one we saw earlier. There are three graphs. The leftmost one has 10 documents in the context window. The middle one has 20, and the rightmost one has 30 documents in the context window. The rightmost one has the largest context window. And that's also where you see this U-shaped curve showing up as the most pronounced. They've done the experiment with a number of models, with Claude, with GPT 3.5 Turbo, some open source LLMs, and they all seem to exhibit this behavior. So to summarize, we see two big takeaways. The first one is that the performance of the model is highest when the relevant information appears either at the beginning or the end of the input prompt. And the second conclusion they draw is that model performance decreases as the input prompts get longer. You can see that a little bit in these three graphs. The bottom of the U in the rightmost graph with the longest context window is lower than the bottom of the U in the other two graphs. But you can also see it more straightforwardly in this graph where the number of documents in the context is on the x-axis and accuracy is on the y-axis. And the other thing that they noticed was in cases where LLMs come in two flavors, where one of them allows a larger context than the other one, the flavor with the larger context does not necessarily give better performance on the task. They found, for example, that the 16K context window version of GPT 3.5 Turbo did about the same as the regular GPT 3.5 Turbo with a much shorter context window. The authors here are essentially saying that all the hype around these recent announcements about LLMs with giant context windows needs to be tempered a bit because they aren't the panacea that everyone thought they would be. Ironically enough, one of the ways in which you can address this is by having a good ranking of the documents that you put into the context window. And this goes back to plain old information retrieval, where you try to rank the documents for a search query using some ranking function, just like web search. So all that old knowledge of how to do effective information retrieval might actually come in very handy, even when doing retrieval with LLMs. If you're curious about how the whole retrieval flow with LLMs works, I've done a separate explainer video on that. I'll link it down in the description. So that was a quick look at this paper, which empirically finds that language models struggle to use information that's in the middle of a very long prompt. And also that having very large prompts or very large context windows doesn't always help performance on the task. I hope you enjoyed that, and I will see you next time. Thank you very much.